So, good afternoon everyone. This is Shiv Krishna, Department of IT, Stand Marketing Engineering College. Today I am doing a topic as compiler. So, last time we discussed what is a compiler, how we can do the compiler process and what are the pages. Basically, compiler is a whatever the high level language, in a simply we write a source program that will be converted into low level language. So that is a compiler. It has a two types of phases. First one is analysis phases. Second one is synthesis phases. So based on these phases, how a compiler will do the high-level programming language to low-level programming language. By understanding these phases, we have several phases. Totally, we have compiler has six phases. First one is lexical analyzer. Semantic analyzers, syntax analyzer, next one is semantic analyzer, next one is intermediate code generator. After this, code optimizer. And finally, code generator. In compiler, every compiler we do the high level programming language to convert to low level programming, we should follow these phases. These phases. What is the first one? We will see one by one. The high level programming language will be converted into low level language. We have several phases. These parallel one by one we will check it. So first one is lexical analyzer, second one is syntax analyzer, third one is semantic analyzer, and fourth one is intermediate code generator, code optimizer, and code generator. So finally we get target output or mission code or mission understanding program, then it will be compiler use, compiles and gives us some errors. So based on this, what is the C one by one phases? So what is the first one? First one nothing but lexical analyzer. What is a lexical analyzer? Lexical analyzer nothing but it will make use sequence of tokens, means whatever the we write the program, that program will be given to sequence of characters, means suppose we are giving a int a comma b, suppose we write a C program, these values we can give say sequence of whatever the sequence of characters we have that will be generated by this lexical analyzer, that will call as a token, sequence of characters we call as tokens. So what is the use of this particular sequence of characters will be generated by using lexical analyzer? By understanding the compiler, easy to identify what is a keyword, what is a variable, what is a number. So by using this sequence of character, lexical analyzer do this process. Easy to understand what is the keyword and what is the variable and what is the number. So that purpose we have lexical analyzer will do on this particular process. Then this output will give to the syntax analyzer. Syntax analyzer will be generate the parsing. Parsing nothing but suppose we have a this sequence of character will be identify how the generator will be generate the what is the keyword and how we can depend. Suppose we have some expression equal to expression plus expression. This is I am giving the particular a keywords means a equal to b plus c. For example, a equal to b plus c. So this is how it is generated the parser tree. Parser is nothing but what is the sequence of character given that particular sequence of character. What is the identifier? What is the keyword? And what is the number? What is the variables? Those values will be taken as input and it will be generated as a parse tree. How it is generated a parse tree? Suppose I am going to explain some this particular equation or this particular expression equal to expression plus expression. How it is generated? First I assign sequence of character in expression. It has it all considered one expression. It consider as three types. One, everything is two. Expression identifier, assignment identifier, assignment operator is identifier by assigning some expression, right? So like this we can generate this we call as a parse tree. Like this we can generate one by one what is the value of each and every keywords are identified. We can generate a parse tree like this. We can expand next with this. A parse tree will be viewed as an input of semantic analyzer. That semantic analyzer will be check the set of rules whether the parse tree is correctly identified or not. How we can do that? Suppose I give a expression equal to expression plus some expression. Here I make a it will consider as a second expression. Now I consider individual expression. The assignment operator will not understand which expression is come first and which expression is come next. So we should follow the set of rules by applying that particular semantic parse tree. Then we will be gives a properly set of parse tree values. Those parse tree values will be used to input of next level intermediate code generator. This intermediate code generator has is considered as an address of temporary variables or gives an address of variables. So based on the address variables, these parse tree will give separate temporary variables to assign. So based on temporary variables assigns, the data will be stored on temporary memory. So based on temporary memory, that value will be stored on each and every temporary variables. So those occupied by number of temporary memories, that will give to the next input of code optimization. What is the use of this particular code optimization? Nothing but so whatever the temporary variables to assign. Suppose I am assigning a this is one temporary variable expression equal to some expression. This expression I am assigning one of the expression I am assigning this is a one temporary variable. This is one temporary variable I am assigning. Suppose this one, this is two, this is three. Temporary variable one equal to expression one. Temp two equal to expression two. Plus temp 1 because of temporary variable expression plus expression 2 equal to some expression 3. Suppose I am giving the some one assign some expression 1 is a one temporary variable. Again adding some expression 2 into another temporary variable assigned into another temporary memory location temporary 2. Then temp 3 equal to temp 2 equal to everything right expression 3. Temp 2 equal to expression 3. How I can consider this expression 3 equal to expression plus expression 1. So I am giving the temporary variable for expression 1 it is one temporary variable. What is the value assigned to expression 1 is given to temporary variable 1. Then expression, it is added by another expression. It is added by another expression. Temporary variable 2, temp 2 equal to temp 1 plus expression 2. Temp 1 plus expression 2. Temp 1 plus expression 2. By this construct another temporary variable, I am assigning total number of 2 variables on particular intermediate code. Here code optimization. So we consume this particular temporary variable memory allocations. Then it will use come to relocatable memory. Relocatable memory on this particular temporary. Wastage of whatever the temporary number of temporary memory is given to or assigned to particular, whatever the past is given to that intermediate coded, that temporary memory will be optimized. Because of reduce the number of registers or memory allocation purpose, we will go for optimization process. So by this particular optimization, it is a relocatable operator will be do for reducing the temporary memory, and it will give to input of code generator. That code generator means it will be understand by this particular machine language, there is zeros and ones understanding. It will be used that particular compiler output. It will give compiler output. So here these two are the two phrases we said, right? The first one is here machine dependent and language independent. So first phase, what is the first phase? First phase has up to lexical analysis to code optimization. It is a machine dependent, means whatever we write a high level language, that will be up to intermediate coded, that will be machine dependent and language. There is no need of language here up to whatever the three phases. Here semantic analysis is machine independent and language dependent. Means language dependence means whatever the code optimization means, that will be understood by only sequence of code characters wise, right? That temporary move, suppose it is gives as a move, read, mul means multiplication, add, these type of keywords will be understood by this synthesis analysis phase. That's why it is a language dependent. So here there is no need of machine dependence. So this is a way we can understand the compiler, what is the basic process will be given to this compiler construction or compiler design. Now I am going to give a small example for what is a grammar and how we can explain the grammar depending on this compiler will be compiles different types of grammars. So generally grammar nothing but we can do the process of the compiler, how the this programming, because we know that programming nothing but C programming or Pascal or Python, whatever we write in a high level programming language, that how we can your compiler Python compiler or C compiler or Turbo C compiler, various compilers we have, how it is compiled to all these phrases will be included and give it within a fraction of seconds output. So this particular way of designing the compiler is easy to understand the process to what is the grammar, how it will be runs your regular expression, and it will use whether it is a which grammar. Generally grammar has a two types, top down approach, second one is bottom up approach. So before going to these types of grammar, so we need to understand what is a grammar and what is a regular expression. So how these particular grammar will be comes on which type of approaches we need to understand, right? So we see continue on the this section in next class. Thank you.